Why City Stadium hosted the Zifa Southern Region Division 1 League's biggest match of the season as local leaders Hwange FC were hosted by second-placed Arenel Movers in Week 18 of the league. Hwange unbeaten in the first half of the season, while Arenel Movers were seeking for revenge after losing the reverse fixture in Hwange in Week 17 of the league. With Hwange's lead at the top at 9 points, Arenel Movers were desperate to cut the lead, and it was a perfect opportunity playing at home. The match had a lengthy stoppage just a minute after the start, as referee Vectemba Moyo noticed that the near side corner flag needed some attention. Shortly after the resumption and against the run of play, Arenel Movers were added a free kick after Hwange defender Shane Chimdengo was adjudged to have fouled hard-running Arenel Movers striker Rizin Svanda. Brian Jarabaza's pile drive beating Nedrick Madia to give Arenel the lead. Abel Ndlovu's clever run deceiving the Hwange wall. The Hwange players questioning the free kick awarded to Arenel. The fast-paced encounter was a physical contest with both teams resorting to long balls, bypassing the midfield. Svanda and Elisha Zulu, who was substituted in the first half, had to play with bandaged heads after a clash of heads in the first half. Hwange tried to come back into the match, but found the Arenel defense marshalled by the former Bosa 90 pair of Polite Mwenda and Carlton Siamalonga impenetrable, Edin Kulungwe's effort missing the target by a distance. The second half was much like the first half as the physical contest continued. Striker Ernest Kutimba was also taken out with an injury.
However, there was drama towards the end, as Arenel Movers goalkeeper Winston Chuetu blocked Hwange's Brian Lodger from walking in the goal line facing the Imenyera end, and what looked like an Arenel Movers supporter stormed the pitch, accusing Hwange of using juju. Sanity, however, prevailed and action continued. Hwange continued to pump the ball forward looking for the elusive equalizer, but it just wasn't their day. When the referee blew his whistle to end the match, Arenel Movers celebrated as if they'd won the championship, inflicting Hwange with their first defeat of the season.
Coach Kutsimandire was a relieved man after the encounter, while Hwange coach Edmos Banda was not happy with the officiating.
Last game is Lalele Hwange, but still 1-0. So the gap here going is simple. We have 9 points, we have 9 points. So we have to win the game play. So Tavi and Jenga team, which is one city we want, that's a total.
That was not a free kick at all. That was not a free kick. And I thought it's a mistake, but as the game was going on, Mbona like they asked me some interest.
In other Week 18 results, Bosa 90 were the biggest victors, thrashing hapless Zimbabwe Sons 5-0 at River Stadium, with the first team bound duo of Prince Ndlovu and Daniel Sendami on target. 16-year-old Ndlovu scoring a brace came from Carlton Yanana and Simba Matsire. ZPC Hwange lost ground on the title chase after being held by Mainline to a goalless stalemate in Plumtree. Siwu came from 2 goals down to hold Ndlovu Yanyathela at White City Stadium. Mountain Climbers beat Kesmine in Techmine by 1-0. Pinga Pirates edged Ajax Hotspurs 2-1. Ratanang went down 2-1 to Mossi Rovers in Vic Falls. Emakhandeni Pirates failed to fulfill their fixture against Talent Vision, and it was a walkover 3-0 in favor of Talent Vision. the fixture between Indosagusa and Quality Foods was postponed. Reports indicate that Indosagusa has folded.